So, wow, you've basically programmed the Google self-driving car localization, even though you might not quite know it yet. So let me tell you where we are. We talked about measurement updates, and we talked about motion. And we coded these two routines, sense and move. Now, localization is nothing else but the iteration of sense and move. There's an initial belief that is tossed into this loop. If you sense first, it comes to the left side. And then localization cycles through these move, sense, move, sense, move, sense, move, sense, move, sense cycle. And every time the robot moves, it loses information. That's the way it is. That's because robot motion is inaccurate. And every time it senses, it gains information. That is manifest by the fact that after motion, the probability distribution is a little bit flatter and a bit more spread out. And after sensing, it's focused a little bit more. In fact, as a footnote, there's a measure of information called entropy. And here's one of the many ways you can write it. It's the expected log likelihood of the probability of each grid cell. And without going into detail, this is a measure of information that the distribution has. And it can be shown that the update step, the motion step, makes the entropy go down, and the measurement step makes it go up. So you're really losing and gaining information. I would now love to implement this in our code. So in addition to the two measurements we had before, red and green, I'm going to give you two motions, one and one, which means the robot moves right and right again. Can you compute the posterior distribution if the robot first senses red, then moves right by one, then senses green, then moves right again? And let's start with a uniform prior distribution.